Hello and welcome to an introduction to limits. The goals of this video are to give an informal definition of a limit and also define limits and one-sided limits graphically and numerically. Sometimes it's difficult to put your finger on the exact meaning of a limit, so what I'd like to do is start with an analogy. Let's say, for example, you're at position 1 and there's a fan at position 4. If you want to know the speed of the wind produced by the fan, as x gets close to 4, the exact position of the fan, we would measure the wind speed as we get closer and closer to x equals 4. The problem is we cannot get to the exact position x equals 4, or we would risk serious bodily injury. As a result, we could use the data listed above to conclude that the wind speed of the fan at x equals 4 is approaching 6 miles per hour. Let's take a look at our table. If we start with an x value of 3 and approach positive 4, you can see 3.5, 3.9, and so on. What we're concerned about is what's happening to the value of the function or the y values, and you can see from the table that it is approaching the value of 6. This is the idea behind a limit. Mathematically, we would write this as the limit of s of x as x approaches positive 4 is equal to 6. An informal definition: as x approaches c, the limit of f of x is L, written with this notation. If all values of f of x are close to L, for values of x that are sufficiently close but not equal to c. Sufficiently close would consist of values that are less than and greater than c. Values that are less than would be to the left of c. Values greater than c would be to the right. Some functions may not have limits at specific values of c, and it's very important to note that the value of the limit is not affected by the value of the function at c. Let's take a look at a limit. The limit of f of x as x approaches positive 1. We have the graph and we have a table of values. Let's take a look at the graph first. One thing that might help is to draw a vertical line through x equals 1 so you kind of see where we're approaching. We'll be approaching this vertical line, or you could think of it as a wall, from both the left side and the right side and determine if we're approaching the same value. Again, it's important to note that this function is not even defined at x equals 1, but it may have a limit there. Let's take a look. Graphically, as we approach the value of x equals 1 from the left side, it looks like the y values are approaching negative 1. Let's take a look at the t-table to see if we can verify that. As these x values approach positive 1 from the left, we can see that the y values look like they are approaching negative 1. But in order to determine if it has a limit there, we also have to approach it from the right side. It seems pretty clear as we approach from the right side using this green arrow, we are also approaching a y value of negative 1. Let's look at the table as well. As we approach x equals 1 from values to the right, or greater than 1, here, it does look like we're approaching a y value of negative 1. Therefore, we can conclude that this limit will be equal to negative 1. In general, there are three ways to approach finding limits: the numerical approach, by using a t-table; the graphical approach, by analyzing a graph; and the analytical method, in which you use algebra or calculus. This will be addressed in a future video. Since we now know about this limit notation and roughly what it means, it is a good time to introduce the idea of one-sided limits. If you take a look at the way this limit is written, as x approaches c, and then you look at the notation used down here, the only difference is this one has a negative sign and this one has a positive sign in the upper right-hand corner of c. This notation refers to the limit from the left, or from values that are less than c. This notation refers to a limit from the right, or values that are greater than c. So basically, it's breaking this limit down into the left side and right side. So this theorem follows. As x approaches c, the limit of f of x is L if the limit from the left exists and the limit from the right exists and they're both equal to L. So essentially what this is saying is if the left-sided limit is equal to L. The right-sided limit is equal to L. It follows that the limit will be equal to L. Let's take a look at an example. Consider the following limits. We have two one-sided limits and then the limit. All of these are approaching positive 1. Therefore, I'm going to sketch a wall or a vertical line through x equals 1. This is sometimes called the wall method. The limit of f of x as x approaches 1 from the right side or positive side, graphically that would refer approaching positive 1 along this green arrow. And as we can see that the y values look like they're approaching negative 2. Looking at the table with the green arrow, you can see as x approaches 1 from the right side, it does look like the y values are approaching negative 2. Therefore, the limit from the right is equal to negative 2. Now, if we take a look at this limit, as x approaches positive 1 from the left, on the function we'd be approaching from this right arrow, it looks like the y values now are approaching positive 3. Let's verify that from the table. Again, as we approach positive 1 from the left side, or values that are less than 1, this does verify it's approaching positive 3. Now remember, to find this limit, these two one-sided limits must be the same, and obviously they're not. Therefore, we would conclude that this limit does not exist. So let's take a look at another. Given the function h of x, find the limits. Now the first thing I would probably do is look at the graph of this and possibly make a t-table. Let's start by looking at the graph. This is the kind of graph you would get from your graphing calculator. First thing I'm going to do is draw a vertical line through x equals negative 2 to kind of get a visual of what we're approaching. So we're approaching that yellow wall from the left side, the right side, and then both sides. So if I'm approaching negative 2 from the left, or the negative side, I would be approaching along this red arrow. And what happens in this case, as we get closer and closer to negative 2, the graph goes down indefinitely. Therefore, the value of the function would be approaching negative infinity. For the second one-sided limit, as x approaches negative 2 from the right, or the positive side, we would be approaching from the direction of this green arrow. So as we approach negative 2 from the right, the graph goes up indefinitely. Therefore, the y values, or the function values, would be approaching positive infinity. Well, obviously, these one-sided limits are not approaching the same value. Therefore, we would say this limit does not exist. Now, it's also important to note that infinity and negative infinity themselves don't exist. So I might want to note that in here. But it is common practice to include either infinity or negative infinity when it applies, because it does give additional information. Okay, I hope that helps explain a little bit about the idea of limits and how you can determine them. More videos on limits will follow. Thank you for tuning in and have a wonderful day.